Hello, wonderful people. What's going on? Almost morning here, 11:45. So I'm wishing you good morning early. So I decided to do this video because I received my full bottle. That was a birthday gift that was sent to me long time ago, but I just received it yesterday. I think that is the very first review I did on this line. That was Bode Vetiver. So I have reviewed this before. You guys know, if you follow my channel, I reviewed this before. This was my first fragrance that I reviewed from a sample, which was a gift from one of my brothers. And I don't have the sample anymore. I gave it to another brother and I have this bottle. So I decided, why not I review all three, because I talked about them individually. You can check out my full review on each. I'm not going to be in depth, I'm just going to tell you in general why this line is such a fantastic deal, price wise, quality wise, smell, performance, everything. Is just this whole line, like they have only three. They have bought a Vetiver, they have bought a I think Cedra, the blue one, and then Bode Yuzu. So these three fragrances, yeah, some there's some love. We have one brother named Ernest, I think, Ernest. He posted in our group, he's from Philippines, I think. So I saw his post and I really love these bottles. He has fantastic photography skills that I do not have. And I really wanted to try the whole line. So far now, thank God I have the whole line. So yeah, let's see why this line is good, what's so great about it, what's maybe some of the negatives, so you get like an overall idea. It's a summary, so try to keep the video short. So I don't have the full boxes here, I just gonna show you the bottles. They have 30, 50 and 100 ml I think, or 50 and 100 EDD concentration. So let's start with the first one that I ever talked about. Okay, this is Bode Vetiver. Okay, this bottle looks like Mercedes-Benz Man Intense or something like that bottle, with a nice little cap like typical other ones, and then it has a black color here. That's what differentiate the rest of them, and the caps are really good. I'll just show you the one coloration inside, very good quality caps, and these things have good sprayer. Okay, let's just go. Okay, they're very decent sprayer, not the best, but they do serve the purpose. So Bode Vetiver was the first one, it really impressed me, and I really felt people compared this with this perfume. You can definitely see it. Declaration Cartier, this is also similar to Terre d'Hermes, similarly done I think by Jean-Claude Elena. Perhaps I could be wrong, but do not quote me on that, but I think very similar sort of fragrances. And when you hear the word vetiver, it really gets scary for beginners, because vetiver is such a note not everybody can adopt from the beginning. So this is vetiver down to very, very premium. I would say this is very premium because from Karl Lagerfeld, you know, if you see their resume, not that many big fragrances like Chanel or Dior would produce, or Coach, also not Coach, Prada would produce, but this new lineup, you know, like this is such a, like, you'll spray, you'll be like, whoa, what is this quality? And like, for that price tag, this quality, unbelievable. So what you pay versus what you get, it really, really, really takes you off guard, you know, like catches you off guard. So this one, vetiver, not done to the niche kind of style like Sultan Vetiver or Guerlain or some of the other like Rassasi's vetiver or Grey Vetiver, you know. So this is done in a bit different ways, kind of sweet, kind of mandarin, citrusy, orange opening. And it's really lovely. I mean, opening is so lovely, you fall in love with the top note. So that's what happened with me, and it got me the best performance in this whole line. It lasts a very long time, okay? It's not just a watery, aquatic, just 2 hours gone. Nope, this is a good quality fragrance, sir. All right, so Bode Vetiver, even if you do not like vetiver, I believe, like, let's say you tried some of the cheaper vetivers like David Beckham Instinct, that has a beautiful like peppery vetiver sort of a scent. Then there's a soapy vetiver that comes from CK Eternity, you know, the green juice. This is way safer than those. This is sweeter, citrusy, more fruity, very nice opening. Slowly it takes you to that vetiver, but it doesn't ever get to you to your burning your nose or disturb you. So I think this is really fantastic offering. Bode Vetiver, you should definitely check it out for the price. I think overseas countries you can get this on 20-25 bucks. Here it's more like $35, you know, around that price range. So definitely check it out. 100 ml bottle would serve you for a very long time. It's great office, everyday scent. And this is the first one. Second one, I already review all this, but I'll just show you once again. I bought this first recent days, Bode Cedra. Boa basically means, I think, woody. And this line is not that woody, to be honest. They have differences. So I saw the bottle, I fell in love with it. I love the color blue. So the thing is, best thing about this perfume is not really full on aquatic. It's more, as I told in my review, it basically is a sweet. Everybody knows this smell, that smells like washing machine. I read it in Fragrantica comment, one son told his son, I mean father, and I can totally see it. It's just fresh, clean, invigorating, little bit aquatic touch with some sweetness. It's just so nice. It's just so nice to wear. It sits on your clothes, like on yourself, like a second skin or something. So good to wear, you know, like in the office, gym, sport, every day. You'll get decent performance out of it. Not a beast, but decent performer like the rest of them. So bodice head dress also very, very good for your video usage. So that's the second one. Third one is just updating his body yuzu, okay? This is the green one. So when you see green, you know, you'll be like a yuzu. And I did say, I heard somewhere, like this fragrance is some people say it's like a what? Isimia Kelodis Sepurum. I have that somewhere here. So some people say this is a clone. I say already discussed it, but it has some yuzu in it, but not as aggressive as Isimia Kelodis or as sweet. This is more like a tart citrus. So the update on this one, it's really growing on me. This is first thing you want to put on yourself, like you feel like Mugler cologne. Of course, not saying this is that fragrance, but it's in the same style. So it's very relaxing, you know, you just want to sit, you know, put your robe on, lay back, you know, you're brushing your teeth, you're like, oh yeah, you know. So sort of like, you know, enjoying a green tea in the morning. This is the fragrance, you know, it's so nice, it's long lasting, and mostly you get like very mouth watering citruses and yuzu, lime, you know, and a little bit of green citrusy feel all the way, but very linear sense. All of these, they do not change so much. So what I really like about this whole line, when you see these bottles, I mean, if you see them side by side, if you actually look at a line, you know, this is sort of like a line you can collect, you can afford, you can get it under $100 or maybe much cheaper. You look for deals. So you get 300 ml of grape juice, you know, of Karl Lagerfeld. This is a worthy line. That's what I'm trying to say. That's why I'm doing this summary. You can buy a lot of fragrances. They do not really have this sort of quality. So Karl Lagerfeld is a lesser known house, perhaps. That's why people do not look at it. I'm a YouTube reviewer, so I have that sort of like a place where I can bring you something so you look at it actually. So yeah, I would highly recommend these three fragrances. Definitely give them a try. Sniff them out in the shopping mall. Perhaps you like the smell, and see it on the paper if you like it on the skin as well. I think for the price, hard to beat this quality. So that's about it. Boa line from Karl Lagerfeld. Boa de Cedra, Boa de Yuzu, Boa de Vetiva. These are all more or less like I give like 8-9 around that for the value. So take care guys, thanks for watching, and I'll move on to the second review. It's a female perfume, latest release, and I'm really excited to talk about this one. Okay, take care guys, good night from Dhaka, Bangladesh. Bye bye.